this. Listen to this. You know what makes the devil so mad?
What?
The devil, and this is just, I can't wait to preach this. I don't know how I'm going to put it together. I can't wait to preach this. So the devil, he messed up one time. Messed up one time. And he gets thrown out. And he's God's angel. He's right there, just one of the worshipers. He gets thrown out of heaven. And he shows up, and he shows up at Miracle Deliverance Tabernacle or wherever I'm preaching. And he looks at Anthony, looks at all the people, and he says, God, they're a mess. You give them 1,000 changes. I messed up one time. What's so different about them? We accepted the blood. We were human beings made in his likeness and his image. And so that's why the devil's just on steroids right now. He's so mad because the Lord just keeps picking us up and helping us and touching us. But I hear a cry now. If you'll draw nigh to me, I'll draw nigh to you. I hear a cry right now. And you just said it, Michael. There's things in people's childhood. There's people, things in the first marriage. There's things in the past church. There's wounds that just never heal. Don't let it keep being a wound. Let it heal over and be a scar. Be like Paul. I bear in my body the marks. That's a scar. Devil, you hit me, and I'm still here. You cut me, and I bled, and I cried, but I got up, and I won.
You know, and there's glory in those things.
There you go.
We're just going through Egypt right now, and they got the tabernacle in the wilderness. And you look in a wilderness, there's no need for gold. There's no need for currency. And God tells them, before you leave, go to your Egyptian neighbor and get some gold, get some jewels. And I was telling Jesse, they leave their Egyptian neighbor, and they're like, oh, we got all this money. We got all this good stuff. And some of these things that look useful become burdens. So when they hit that wilderness, they're out there with this weight. They're out there with this pain. They're out there with this thing that they don't know what to do with. And in their life, it's useless. But when they gave it to Moses, it became the very candlestick that held glory. It became the altar. It became the ark. And I think some of this stuff in our life, we look back and we say, this is just a burden. This is just pain. And we keep carrying it. But there's a call, just like Moses, to those people. You're giving a call out today. If you give this to me, it can be a place for glory.